Hello, I'm Nadia, and let us see the experiment number 4 in Signals and Systems Laboratory. The object of our experiment is to create a MATLAB code to perform linear convolution and then finding the outputs of the systems and studying the function of the systems based on the results and creating difference equations to remove trends and studying the properties of the systems. Let us see the convolution function. I am defining a function yn is equals to con xn comma hn. Here xn and hn are the inputs what we give and yn is the output signal what we get. The L1 and L2 are the lengths of xn and hn. As we know, for a convolved signal, the length is sum of impulse response length plus sum of input signal length minus 1. So that is m. So I am creating array of m zeros and making the lengths of xn and hn same as the convolved signal, that is equal to m, length of xn and hn equals to m, and writing the equations using the for loop and using stem and x label, y label, title commands to plot the signals. So we can use this convolution function for any input signal what we want to get as output. So let us see the impulse responses for the systems, four systems given. The first system yn is equals to 1/3 xn plus xn minus 1 plus xn minus 2. The impulse response is the output when we give input as an impulse function. So let us define the systems so that we can get. So here xn is equals to input of we are asking for the input, and xn1 is the delayed version of xn by 1 and xn2 is the delayed version of xn by n is equals to 2, and making the lengths of xn equal to xn1 and xn2 and writing the equation yn is equals to 1/3 xn plus xn plus xn1 plus xn2, we can get the output. So here I am giving the input as delta function 1 and I got the output as 1/3, 1/3, 1/3, and the graph of the output function, that is impulse response. So for a system 2, that is the system 2 is yn is equals to 1/m from sigma k is equals to 0 to m minus 1 x of n minus k. So to define this system, here xn is equals to input data. Like if we give the input in an array form, we use input of the something, and to extract the data from a file, we use import data. And here d is the length of xn and k is the input and the values of k, like m is equals to 25, 50 and 100, and we are creating a zeros, d plus k zeros, and we are defining the system. Similarly, system 3, in the same manner as system 1, we are writing the equation yn is equals to xn minus xn1, and we got the impulse response as 1 and minus 1 and the graph of the impulse response. Here it is 1 at 0 and minus 1 at 1. For the system 4, it is yn is equals to 1/2 xn minus 1/2 xn minus 2. So we got the output as 1/2, 0 and minus 1/2, and the graph looks like this is 0.50 and it is 0 at 1 and it is minus 1 at 1 minus 1/2 at 2. So these are the impulse responses. Now let us sketch the outputs for the signals given, for the four signals provided. So for the first system, we are importing the data, we are extracting the data from the file provided and using the import data, and we are using the convolution function yn is equals to convolution of xn comma hn. So that we can giving the impulse response what we found before, that is 1/3, 1/3, 1/3, we can get the output signal. This is the output signal. And similarly for system 2, we define the system before, and we are giving the signal. This signal, and we can give any signal in the four signals, and the entering the impulse responses, we can get the output signal. So the output signals look like this is the output when m is equals to 25. This is the output when m is equals to 50, and this is the output when m is equals to 100. Similarly, for the third one, we enter the impulse responses 1 and minus 1, and we can get the output convolve signal. For the fourth system, we give the impulse responses 1 by 2, 0 and minus 1 by 2, and we get the output convolve signal as this. Similarly, for all the signals, we can find the convolve signals. Now, let us see the how to remove the trend. So, removing trend means nothing but removing the delayed version in input gives us the actual fluctuations in the data. Here, this system 1 by n is equals to 1 by m summation of xn minus k from k is equals to 0 to m minus 1. This is a moving average system. This is also called as low pass filter because it removes the high frequency components that are superimposed on the actual pulse signal. So if generally order of m is high, it becomes a narrow pass filter. Let us see the code. So we define the system as before, and we are writing the extra equation on is equals to xn minus zn. That is, we are removing the trend from the input signal. So this is the actual PPG signal. Let us see for m is equal to 100. So this is the actual PPG signal. We can see there is some shift here. That is, the baseline is somewhat shifted. So to remove that shift, we are subtracting these spikes from the input signal. This is the output of the system, which is the moving average system. We are subtracting this from the input signal so that from after removing trend, we can see that the shifting is less, it is avoided. So generally we prefer to take higher values of m. If the values of m is higher, we get the smooth curve, that is very low frequencies, close to zero, we get, and we only subtract them. Similarly for the second signal, so when m is equal to 100, we can see here there is a somewhat shift, and we are removing that shift, and we are getting the output signal like this. And similarly for the third one and fourth one, we can get in the similar way. Now let us see the properties of the systems. This first system, this is a moving average system. Like, we are essentially taking an average of xn, xn minus 1 and xn minus 2. It is linear, time invariant. The time invariant is, time invariant system is which, if we give a delayed input, we get a delayed output. So if we give a input as x of n minus n0, we get output as y of n minus n0. So it is time invariant. It is stable, because for a bounded input, we get a bounded output. And it is also memoryless system because it depends on previous inputs. Previous inputs, and it is a causal system because it is depending on only present and previous inputs. Similarly, the second system, it is linear, time invariant, stable, memoryless and causal system. And for the third one, it is linear, time invariant, because we get a delayed input output. If we give delayed input, it is also stable and memoryless causal system, and it